tech news. That's the intro. Now that the metaverse is definitely a thing and not just a buzzword being used inappropriately everywhere, Apple is getting serious about its long-rumored AR headset. Renowned Apple leaker and rumor monger Ming-Chi Kuo says Apple will launch the device in the fourth quarter of 2022 with two processors, a lower-end chip to handle sensor data and another one with the same level of computing power as M1. So this is gonna be like having a Mac Mini strapped to your face?
The Maciverse.
The maculous, immaculate inception. Kuo says to expect a headset with 4K OLED displays for each eye made by Sony and the ability to operate untethered, not from the App Store, though. From an iPhone or Mac, Zuckerberg won't even know what hit him. But maybe it won't hit him though, because he's so good with the arms up, he's ready. He's like, wah! You know what I'm talking about though.
I don't know, I can imagine.
No, it's from the meta.
Okay.
It's from the meta thing. It's a meme. While America struggles with what to do about big tech's growing power, other nations are making moves. Italy is the latest country to take a shot at the oligarchs, announcing around 10 million euro fines for both Apple and Google for neglecting to inform users about how their personal data is being collected and used.
Now, what's the matter, you?
Oh, come on! This is what we think of as talents. That's like neglecting to boil the water before you put the pasta in.
Olive oil in there.
A little salt. Both companies are appealing the fines, even though 10 million is a drop in the bucket compared to the tens of billions of dollars in revenue the companies have made so far this year. And this is actually the second round of fines Italy has issued this week, slapping Apple and Amazon with a combined $230 million fine a few days ago for collusion regarding restrictions on sales of used Apple products.
Ciao.
Fines which are also being appealed, but I doubt they're gonna get anywhere. Have you tried arguing with an Italian person? It's impossible. And SpaceX successfully launched NASA's Double Asteroid Redirection Test, or DART, mission this week aboard a Falcon 9 rocket. As its name implies, the mission will see a spacecraft deliberately smash into an asteroid to see whether we could redirect one on a collision course with Earth.
Space garbage.
Space garbage.
Meet space garbage. His boy Elon.
All right. Unfortunately, there's no nuclear weapons or Bruce Willis is involved in this mission.
Grimes, his wife.
And the asteroid is actually two orbiting bodies, the larger Didymos and the smaller Dimorphos, which are about to be forcefully broken up, even though they did nothing wrong. But NASA's also undertaking a less violent mission on the surface of Mars using a seismograph set up by the InSight lander to image the first few hundred meters under the planet's surface. Although if we happen to cross paths with the Martian mole people, things might get ugly. Because they're, have you seen them? They're just, I can't look. They're real.
Mole people.
You're just like the musical accompaniment. Wardrobe change! Now it's time for Quick Bits, brought to you by NZXT's Build System, which makes getting a custom-built PC as easy as ordering food. But it's like the good way where you can customize it and add extra mayo, but hold the jalapenos because too spicy. Simply set your budget, see how your PC will perform in your favorite games, and let Build take care of the rest, because their recommendation engine provides benchmark data guaranteed to be within 10% accuracy. There's transparent pricing, a flat $99 assembly fee, and everything's covered under one warranty plan with NZXT's excellent customer support. Orders are built and shipped within 48 business hours, and it's even available in Australia now too! So check out NZXT's Build System today at the link below. Quick Bits!
Gotta have them!
Gotta eat them.
Can't live without them.
Nom nums.
Careful when you poop them.
The good news for Linux gamers just keeps on coming. Valve has added support for NVIDIA's DLSS to its latest Proton build, which will allow the tech to work in games that support it. Unfortunately, Valve's own Steam Deck won't receive any benefit from this, as it runs on an AMD processor, but the deck will support Team Red's own FSR sharpening method when it launches next year, so let's just celebrate the fact that gaming on Linux is more of an option than ever, especially if you don't mind troubleshooting for a few days beforehand.
Let's game!
Whoosh. The UK has introduced a bill that would ban the use of default passwords on smart home devices. We're talking real dumb stuff like password, admin, 12345.
Hey, that's mine.
You should have tried the best one, password one. Default passwords can make things super easy for attackers, like the ones that stole data from a casino in 2017 by accessing an interconnected fish tank. Were the fish in on it? We may never know.
It's fishy.
They were sadly flushed without a trial. NVIDIA has made the image-generating AI behind its Canvas software even better. Now, you don't even have to draw something for the algorithm to transform it into a realistic landscape. You can just type some words, and the machine will create something that looks straight out of a stock photo library. Unfortunately, you can't type just anything in there, as the system was trained on 10 million images of landscapes only.
No cheese?
No, so whatever gross thing you're thinking of right now will have to stay locked up in that messed up head of yours, man. Seriously, you should get some help. Cheese in that scenario?
Still life? Classic.
Microsoft's backwards compatibility program for old Xbox games has been awesome, especially since many titles have benefited from the company's FPS boost technology. But now, Xbox's Jason Ronald,
known as J-Ro,
by you, has said further rollout of FPS boost is on hiatus as his team is starting to find limitations in their current technique. Which sucks, but it's also surprising that Microsoft would just admit they're having trouble with something. That's big of them. This kind of feels like the old days, right down to the forcing people to use their browser. And French car maker Renault has shown off a quad-rotor flying version of its classic Renault 4 hatchback called the Air 4.
Sued by Apple.
Gotcha. The company said it's designed for the roads of the future that are visualized to be in the air. That's what they meant to say, which I'm guessing is an idea based off of Back to the Future 2, because the roads in the, that's not, anyways, the Air 4 is powered by 22,000 milliamp hour batteries, but that doesn't matter because you can't buy this thing. It's just cool. Just look at it. That's all you're supposed to do. There's no analysis here. Okay. It's just, oh, cool, nice.
Would you look at that?
Ah, it's a flying car.
Just look at it.
Wow. What's not nice is that this episode has to end. Come back on Monday for more tech news. And I'll show you all my Black Friday purchases.
22,000 milliamp hour batteries.
1,000 of them individually. Yeah. Just kidding, I didn't buy anything. Minimalism.